Now, I want people to listen to this strapping young gentleman speak from the past of 2021, November, why he's talking about Tesla. And if you don't already know, Tesla is missing their deliveries. It's slowing down. People are no longer buying Tesla. Hertz is having issues with Tesla. Hertz CEO pretty much got fired because no one wants to rent them. BYD is crushing them in China. Let's listen to this strapping young gentleman send out the warnings from about 3 years ago on why he does not own Tesla.
Now, here's my thing about Tesla. Benjamin Graham's book, The Intelligent Investor, if you read that book, I believe it's the commentary in chapter 14. He says, be aware and stay away from CEOs and hedge fund portfolio managers that are always in the news. They always got to be in front of the TV. They always got to be touting their stock or their fund. They always got to stay relevant.
Now let's think about this for a second. He's warning you about people on TV. And what do I warn you about? Stay away from people who always have that day-to-day plays. Okay? They always have the day-to-day plays. Investing is boring, yo. You set it and forget it. Let's let this good-looking gentleman continue.
Elon Musk is always in the news. He's either tweeting something, he's on Joe Rogan's podcast, he's talking about something, Bitcoin and all this. Who's the CEO of Exxon? Who's the CEO of McCormick Spices? Who's the CEO of 3M? Who's the CEO of Procter & Gamble? You will never know unless you Google them because they're never in the news. They know they have a product and it sells itself. What Tesla is doing is, what you're pretty much saying and my whole point of this video is, your hottest stocks of the past will not be your hottest stocks of the future. So
in this video, I'll put the link in the description. It's actually a very good video. I talk about the top 10 stocks that were there in 1999 and year 2000. Nine of them are not even around anymore, or they're not in the top 10. There's only one that's still in the top 10.
If Tesla's trading at 300 and some odd times share earnings, you're paying today for a stock that might not even be in the S&P 500 or might not even be in business. You don't think these people who invested in AOL and Lucid Technologies, all these companies, you don't think they thought their stock was going to be the future? IBM. IBM's revenue has been declining 5, 6, 7 years. Cisco Systems still isn't trading back at the market cap what it was back in 1999. They're still not there. They're still not back where they were. So why would I invest in a company of speculation? There's no moat around it. There's no real moat around Tesla. Every automaker right now is making EV cars.
Now, what I mean by moat is BYD in China is outselling Tesla. That is what I was trying to say back then. It's not like they're the only pretty girl at the dance. There's multiple pretty girls at the dance. And what's hot then won't be hot in the future. And let's fast forward. This is why I'm playing this video for you guys.
I know what people are going to say. Yeah, but they make, housing equipment and solar. Here's what people don't understand.
Sorry to interrupt again, but this was before interest rates even went up. This is when people had stimulus money. So people didn't understand when interest rates go up, people are less likely to buy more expensive cars. They got to put food on the table first and pay rent. Okay? And they're more likely to go cheaper with the cars.
Okay. They're hot right now. But what happens when we do go into a recession? A lot of people are too young. They don't understand what a real recession is because they were born in 2000 or they were born in 1996 and 1997. And they were too young to feel a 2008 housing crisis because they don't really remember unless they went through it and their family lost a home. What I'm saying is this, you throw your money into Tesla because it's the hottest stock. It's on. Everybody knows about it. It's not a secret. Say there's a recession. Who the hell is going to buy a $70,000 to a $200,000 car during a recession?
Remember Teslas were like 50, 60, 70 grand? Oh, now all those people that paid those prices, now they're lowering prices and now they're underwater for their Teslas. Let's look at what a 2021 Tesla is going for now. Wow, just imagine you paid 50 grand for a Model 3. Look at how much you can get a Model 3 for now.
The first people and the first companies that get hit are your car companies. People's cars start getting repoed. Who's going to go out and redo their solar panels when there's a recession, when they might be losing their home? Who's going to buy this car when they can go out and they can buy a used Prius that's a plug-in or it's a hybrid? People think Tesla is the state-of-the-art whatever. No. Honda Insight and Toyota been working on electric cars and hybrid cars for how many years now? Your Chevy Volt was an all-electric car.
Listen, I'm going to put this video in the link in the description. Check it out. Your boy was telling people he was a high school dropout back then, but he never followed the crowd when it came to his finances later on in life, and this is why I'm here trying to help you. But some people will listen and some people won't. Let's take a look at the five likes. Yeah, those five likes, those people probably are doing really good right now.